Good morning, students. I again welcome you in your next class of science. We will start part 2 of lesson 1, that is food. Where does it come from? But before that, we recapitulate which we learned in the previous part. Why do we eat food? We eat food to get energy for doing various activities, for proper growth of our body, for healing the wounds quickly, and to have good immunity. Also, we learned that there are varieties of food according to the people living in different regions, like upma, chole bhature, dosa, vada, idli and sambar, dal makhani, sarso da saag, makki di roti, etc. The materials used to prepare any food item are called ingredients. You must have written the ingredients of various food items, your favorite. So, you know very well that the ingredients, they are the materials which are used to prepare any food item. Also, students, with some examples, we find that some food items are made up of 2 or 3 ingredients, whereas some food items are made of many ingredients, like boiled rice. Boiled rice is made up of rice and water, whereas Shahi Paneer is made up of paneer, cream, butter, tomato, onion, spices, salt and water. So, we can conclude that some items, they are made from few ingredients, and some food items, they are prepared by using many ingredients. Now, the question arises, students, that where do these ingredients come from? Let's consider some examples. Again, we have another food item, pea pulao. So, its ingredients are rice, peas, spices, water, oil or ghee as you use at your home. Food item like chicken curry. Its ingredients are chicken, spices, water, oil or ghee. So, we see that major sources of various food ingredients are either plants or animals. So, we conclude that there are two sources of, these are the two major sources of food ingredients. They are plants or animals. Plants, they are the sources of food like grains, cereals, vegetables and fruits. And also animals, they provide us with milk from which we prepare many milk products like ghee, butter, etc. Then meat products and eggs are also provided by animals. So, we see that there are major two sources of food ingredients, that is plants and animals. So, friend, let's find out one more thing. If any our food comes from sources other than plants and animals, kya hamara koi aur bhi aisi cheez hai khane mein use hoti hai jo aur wo hame plants aur animals se nahi milti balki kahi aur se milti hai? So answer is yes. Like some examples are salt. Salt ke bina khana bilkul swad nahi hota. So salt we get from sea water or rocks. Then we use water for cooking various food items, and that water we get from various sources of water like river, well, tap, ponds, tube well, rain, etc. These are the various sources of water. So now we see that we can see a diagram which is showing the different parts of a plant. And these different parts of a plant are used as different ingredients. I mean to say that the ingredients which we make to make different food items, they are the parts of a plant, the food which we get from plants. Okay, so you can see in the figure that there are mainly two systems in a plant. The portion which is above the ground, it is called the shoot system, and the portion which is under the ground, that is called root system. So in shoot system, you can see flower, fruit, stem, leaf, bud, and you can also see node and internode. Node is that portion from where the leaf arises from the stem. That point is called node, and the space between the two nodes is called internode. Again, you can see the part which is under the ground, that is root system. It has different types of roots. The main root is called primary root, and the other roots which are branched roots, they are called secondary roots. So you can see now these are the different parts of a plant. So the plant parts which are used as food, like we get ingredients from certain parts of a plant. Which parts? Like roots, stem, leaf, flower, fruit, bud, and seeds. And so these parts are called edible or eatable, kyunki hum khate hain inhe. These are called the eatable or edible parts of a plant. So we see that various fruits and vegetables which we use as food, they are the different parts of a plant. Now, with the help of example, it will be more clear to you. Like first of all, we take roots like carrot, radish, turnip, sweet potato, as you can see in the figure. All these are the root part of a plant. Okay. Now, next is stem. Examples you can see potato, onion, ginger. These are also the stem part of the plant. Means if we eat potato, then we are eating a stem of a potato plant. Okay. So now next you can see some figure which are leafy part of a plant. That is spinach, palak, lettuce, mustard, and fenugreek. You can see the seeds as well as the leaves of fenugreek. So these are green vegetables, very good for health. Okay, next you can see the flower. Flower is also a part of plant, and cauliflower, pumpkin flower, banana flower, also used as a vegetable, and these are the flower part of a plant. Which parts of a plant? These are the flower parts of a plant. Next, we can see some fruits, fresh apples, beautiful bananas you can see, and juicy mangoes, mouth watering fruits. Okay, some more examples, some vegetables which are also the fruit part of a plant, like cucumber, brinjal. The vegetables which have seeds, they are called the fruit part of a plant. Then you can see bud. Bud, like example, is clove, long. And it is also used as a painkiller. When we have pain in our tooth, it relieves us from that pain. It is a bud part of a plant. And it is used as a spice also. Very good for health. So, various food items produced by plants are as follows, like cereals, pulses, vegetables and fruits, oil seeds, sugar, tea and coffee, spices, etc. In cereals, you can see some examples are like rice, wheat, sorghum, jawar jise hum kehte hain, millet, etc. Pulses, daale, jinhe hum hindi mein daale kehte hain, gram, peas, pigeon pea, soya bean, etc. Vegetables and fruits you know very well. And oil seeds like mustard oil, we get from the seeds of mustard plant. Groundnut oil we get from the seeds of groundnut plant. Cotton seed oil is also good for health. Then sugar, sugar we get from sugarcane or beetroot also. They are the main sources of sugar. Then tea and coffee. These are obtained from leaves of tea and coffee from seeds of coffee and cocoa. Okay, then spices. Spices are also that part of our plant which add taste and flavor to our food item. Various examples of spices are like pepper, mirchi, kali mirch, black pepper, cardamom, cumin, jeera, cloves, abhi jaise humne padha, long, turmeric, haldi, good for health, etc. So, students, we see that various food items are the various parts of a plant. The food item that we get from plants, they are the part of a plant. So, now you have some questions as homework also. Question that is, draw a well-labeled diagram of the different parts of a plant in a notebook. You will prepare a notebook in which you will do the questions which are given as homework in part 1 also. Now in part 2. Name 2 of each other than given in the video. Root vegetables, stem vegetables and fruit vegetables. Question 3 is, write down the famous food items of any 10 states of India. And then question 4, name the various food items produced by plants. You can take the help of this video also. So, I hope the topic is clear to you. And then we will again meet with third part of this lesson. Till then, bye and stay safe, stay at your home. Thank you.